really far away from the camera. I don't know if that looks... Okay. Sun's in my eyes. Okay. I had a dream last night. It was kind of a weird dream. I was at my graduation. I was doing a speech. And I could see everyone that I loved sort of at the graduation. And it kind of made me realise what I'm working, you know, working towards, the people that are there for me, you know, family and friends, girlfriend, you know, best friends. And it kind of gave me the kick up the backside that I kind of needed. I haven't really been as productive as what I'd like to be. I haven't been doing things I enjoy the most. I'm feeling very happy with what I've got at the moment. You know, I've got a good relationship now. Got my best friends. You know, I've got a good bond with my flatmates. We all get on quite well. But I've stopped doing stuff that I enjoy, like, you know, reading books, exercise, recording videos quite frequently. And it kind of gave me the, you know, kick up the bum. So, I'm going to start doing the things that I enjoy. And I think that will make me a much, much better person in myself. And I'm going to be more productive in my work. So, making more to-do lists is what I used to do. You know, making to-do lists, structurizing my work accordingly. And I'm going to show you guys how I do that in future videos. So if you are interested in that kind of stuff, then you know, stay tuned for that. So just wanted to get it out there. So maybe this is like a kind of turning point for me, really. I've got my mock exam for my anatomy and physiology coming up on the 13th of December. So that's a big month for me. It's my first proper exam for a couple of years now. So I am kind of nervous about it, and it's like an anatomy and physiology exam. So, you know, everyone's scared of anatomy and physiology exams. So yeah. I'm gonna speak about now my first week on placement, answer a couple of questions that people might have. Hopefully, if I don't, drop it down in the comments so I can, you know, answer them if need be. But yeah. First, also, I've been trying to work my camera. It's a G7X. And it's only recording in 720, so I'm currently using my phone, so I'm sorry if the quality is not amazing. But if anyone knows anything about a G7X, please message me on any social media platform and it'll probably help. So, the first week of placement. So, when you get put on placement, you'll be told how many hours you have to do. I have to do 150 hours per block of placement, and I think at the end of it, you'll be doing 650 hours. That's my university. 600 or 650. So my first placement, as I mentioned in my first video, if you haven't seen that video, go and check it out now. I go over what I'm doing on placement, basically. So I'm not going to go too much into that, but I'm in a care home. But this care home is classed as a nursing home, but it's also like a rehabilitation ward. So, say for example, an elderly person breaks their leg, they go into hospital, they then have the operation. They can't be discharged from hospital because they haven't got the support at home that maybe they need. You know, they haven't maybe got someone that can look after them 24/7. So they come to this ward for them to find either a care home, you know, a placement somewhere else, or for them to have support put in place at home before they are discharged from hospital. So I think I'm very lucky because I've worked in a care home. I've done St John Ambulance, I've got the first day kind of just the things. I've now been put into like a rehabilitation ward. So I've been watching assessments, it's on my first week, I've been watching assessments done by the manager. So she goes off and assesses people to see if they're deemed, if we can meet their needs in this kind of ward, care home. So I've seen all that, I've seen all the laws that are involved in doing that, you know, the Mental Capacity Act and all them sort of interesting stuff. And I found that really lucky, so I've been doing that as well. And then after I finish this placement, I'm going to accident and emergency. which I'll be, you know, learning all, you know, I'm seeing stuff, you know, on the front line basically. And I can put the skills that I have been at university properly to the test then. So that'd be interesting. Then I go on to PTS. So I'll be going into people's homes, you know, looking at maybe the you know, in going into people's homes when they're vulnerable. Not everyone lives in this mansion that we all, you know, everyone lives in this nice house. We're going to see stuff and we're going to go into people's homes. So, you know, dignity and respect comes into this now as a big role. And the interpersonal skills that you developed at university on placements in the past as well, all come to the test then, I feel, on PTS. And then in April, I'll be on the frontline ambulance responding to emergency calls, which has been a dream of mine since, you know, I was this big. So it's all, I'm all looking forward to it, but I'm just going to talk about now the hours that I've done. I know a couple of people have been asking what the hours are like on your placement. What do I do? Can I do this? What have you done? So I'm going to answer that question. So I did my first week, I did an introduction, so a 9 till 4, and she sort of took me around the home, and then after about 12, had like a little break, and then I met the residents, and I was placed with like a more experienced mentor, which I found quite good, because if I have any questions, I can sort of follow them around. So that was all really for that day. I didn't really learn anything as such, because I was just following someone around, and just getting used to what the home was. I did like my research beforehand, so I knew sort of the gist of things. But it was a good day. It was nice, and it sort of pushed me in gently. Don't think that they're going to push you in into the deep end in these placements. They're not there to scare you. They're just there to get what you want. So hopefully, if the placement's good, they'll sort of say, well, what do you want off us? And then they sort of just let you go on with it, really. So the manager said, well, what are you expecting from us? What do you want to get from his placement? And I told him everything then that what I wanted to get from the placement. So the second day, it was my first proper shift. So it was a 12-hour shift, 8 o'clock in the morning until 8 at night. We need to be there 15 minutes before our shift started for the handover. So we started at 7:45, and we went in. We did like a little handover, so we did like a walk around the home. The nurse that did on the night shift would tell you everything that was concerned about for the patients, so if anything happened through the night, so you know then to look out for it in future. On the shift. And then my roles were to then, I wouldn't say I was put with someone. There was three carers and then there was me, so I was like a supernumerary role kind of thing. So I wasn't classed as a number as such, but I was sort of there to do the jobs. She asked me if I wanted to do any personal care. I said I don't really mind, but university did say not to do personal care. You're not there as a number, which I wasn't. So I assisted with washes, you know, putting people in the hoists, doing bed baths. What else did I do? Help serve dinner, help feed people. You know, everything that I do at my care home, I did. But the thing that most people don't get at care homes is, it's very important, is you build a lot more skills than what you actually realise. If you're sitting down with someone, feeding them their dinner, imagine if you was that person that you was feeding, you know, someone's feeding you. The trust and how low that you must feel in order to, because I would hate for someone to feed me my dinner. So you need to build up this resilience and bond with these patients, because you're going to be there for 5 weeks. So it takes a lot of skills, you know, communication skills, listening skills, because when you're feeding them their dinner, they tell you quite a lot about their life, and it's very interesting. I've learned so many things on this first week already about people's lives. There was a lady that was in the war. She was telling me everything about what she did in the war. It was amazing. And just learn about people's lives. You know, you don't have to go into this big RTC to learn the core skills that you need to develop you as a person, as a competent clinician. I think at a care home, you build the core skills very, very well. For example, we got this lady on a hoist. She was very distressed by the hoist. So this lady, she couldn't really weight bear at all. So she was very, I think she had early stages of dementia. And you sort of have to risk assess of the situation. So when you do your moving the hand in training, you're taught a lot about you know, the things that you look for on an assessment. This lady, she hated the hoist. She was very confused on where she was, and she didn't want to go in it at all, basically. I sort of reassured her. I told her what we was going to do, the importance of what we was going to do, because she's on like a 2 hour turn, because she has pressure sores on the bottom. So we basically had to sit her in the chair for a bit because she was having dinner, and she understood, gave her a wash, and after this she was very thankful for what we did. We sat her in the chair, she had a dinner. And I think, and then that's what I mean, if you're not very good at communicating with someone or listening to someone, and you didn't really assess the scene, you went straight into it, you put her into the hoist, it's going to make the situation worse. And the poor lady who's got dementia, she's not going to trust you when you're lifting her up off the bed in this big machine, is what they see it. I've sat in the hoist before, and it's quite scary to do that. So yeah, that was my first shift. It was a 12-hour shift, and it was good. I really enjoyed it. So I did Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. So I had like sort of days in between where I can revise and rest, which was really good for me. So I did Monday, which was the introduction, pardon me, 9 till 4. Then I had Tuesday, which was like a revision day. So I revised a couple of topics then, which helped a lot. Wednesday was my 12-hour shift. Thursday, revision day. Friday, I did another 12-hour shift. By Friday, I felt much more confident in what I was doing. Instead of being told to maybe go make someone a cup of tea, I just did it. You know, you build up this routine in your head of what to do, and you become more confident in doing the little jobs. Don't feel as though, because you know you're new, you feel as though I shouldn't ask what to do. You're not going to know what to do straight away, basically. So don't feel scared to say, now what do I do? Because in the future you will know what to do, so you'll just do it naturally. So I went in, I made a list of what everyone has, all the names, and I went round and asked what I want for breakfast. On Monday and Wednesday, I didn't really know what to do. So on Wednesday, I asked, you know, what do we do now? And they said, just go around and ask what people want for breakfast. So I did. And then, you know, by the end of the week, I was very confident in what I was doing. And I feel as though much more into the team now. So yeah, that was my first week. 12-hour shifts, you have to get used to them. It's just part of the job, really. They are long shifts, but you have to get used to them, really. And while you're doing these 12-hour shifts, you need to fill out your competencies and getting your hours signed off for university, which is good. But also very stressful, because if you miss a signature, you have to go back and you have to always keep asking your mentor, you know, can you sign this, can you sign that? Don't feel scared to ask your mentor, can you sign this? I did that on my first day, and I regretted it, because I had to go and ask her, can you sign this? So it's just be open, and just be open to learn what you want to do in university and how it's going to develop you for your next placement, which for me would be E&E. So yeah, that was my first week. If you have any questions, please drop down below, and I will be looking forward for you for the next video when I talk about week 2 on placement.